Alfred Wegener was a German researcher. His main subjects were meteorology and polar exploration. One day, he noticed something while looking at a map of the Earth. The shapes of the continents of the Earth were shaped like a puzzle. That is, they are arranged in such a way that they fit with each other if placed together. This came as a huge shock to him. He began to wonder why this was so. But no matter how much he tried, Alfred could not find the answer. Suddenly, he had a thought. What if these continents were together at one time? That is, what if the continents were moving? If we take the world map and look at it carefully, like a puzzle game, we can understand one thing. If we move the Atlantic Ocean out of the way, South America and Africa blend together perfectly. That is, they were together at one point and were then separated. Alfred Wegener's thoughts went in that direction as well. Thus, he came to the conclusion that the continents are in motion. He decided to study this in more detail to confirm his conclusion. He assumed that, centuries ago, all the continents were united in a single continent. He called it Pangaea. Pangaea is a Greek expression meaning all lands or the whole earth. However, Wegener believed that the continent's movement to reach the places we see today were very slow and had been going on for ages. He called this process continental drift. He began to look for evidence to prove that this theory was correct. Fossil record is a form of evidence that strongly supports the theory of continental drift. Fossils of similar plants and animals have been found in the rocks of the same age on the shores of different continents. For example, the remains of freshwater reptiles such as the crocodile, which lived between 286 and 258 million years during the Permian period, have been found in South Africa and Southeast America. They are called Mesosaurus. But not only the Mesosaurus, but the endangered mammal-like reptile Cygnonathus, which was as large as a modern wolf, were found in South Africa and South America. Fossils of the reptile Lystrosaurus are found only in Antarctica, India, and South Africa. The fourth one is Glossopteris, which looks like a shrub or tree. Their fossils have been found in Australia, South Africa, South America, India, and Antarctica. Glossopteris, which had very heavy seeds, could not move in the wind or flow through the ocean. Therefore, these fossils, which have been found in various places, are very much in line with Wegener's theory. Rocks of the same age and kind are found on both sides of the Atlantic Ocean. Wegener commented that the rocks formed one after the other and then split onto two sides. These mountains are now on the opposite sides of the Atlantic Ocean, with the same rocks and structures. For example, the mountain range of the Appalachians in the United States and Canada is very similar to the mountain range found in Greenland, Ireland, Britain, and Norway. According to Wegener, these were formed as a single mountain range and then separated by the movement of continents. Glacier is the process by which snow accumulates and flows along mountains or poles, forming an ice river. But if this glacier flows over the rocks, large cracks can be seen on those places. These are called glacial striations. However, in South America, Africa, Madagascar, Arabia, India, Antarctica, and Australia, widespread distribution of the glacial debris from the Permo-Carboniferous period was observed. These glacial striations can now be found in the tropical rainforests of South Africa and America. Rainforests are forests with hot and humid climates. Moreover, these are very hot places which lie near the equator. So how were glacial stratifications found in the places along the equator? There is only one reason to answer that. These tropical rainforests once existed in a cold area. This means that all of these forests we see today may have once been near the South Pole. So Wegener collected all the evidence. But in the eyes of scientists, his theory was still a joke, because Wegener was still unable to answer one of their key questions. Why does this movement actually occur? So he began to search for the answer to that question. But he didn't have to search for much longer. As part of the investigation, Wegener made a voyage to the North Pole. It was a time when it got frequent storms and the place was getting very cold then. Even though he was very courageous, his body was starting to get tired. And so, Alfred Wegener died on the spot. He died long before his theory was accepted by the world. It was only later that scientists found the answer to his remaining question. Plate tectonics theory originated in further studies regarding this. The Earth has three layers: core, mantle, crust. We exist on the crust, but the lower parts of the crust are not a single solid land, but like pieces. They are called tectonic plates. This layer of crust is the one moving. This movement is only about 1 to 10 centimeters per year, and the movement of these plates is called plate tectonics. The lithosphere is the part of the Earth filled with land. These tectonic plates move in three ways. When they move in the same direction, it is called convergent boundaries. When they move in the same direction and collide with each other, they rise and form mountains. But when these two plates move in opposite direction, there is a gap. The Mid-Atlantic Ridge was formed after this gap. The third movement is called transform boundaries, that is, the process by which one plate goes up and the next plate goes down. This is how earthquakes are formed. But researchers are still trying to figure out the origin of this movement. Studies are also underway to determine if the Pangaea, which has been split for many years, will be reunited for years. There is no point in saying we could wait and see, because this is not something that will happen in our lifetime. But we can be proud of the fact that we can understand something that will not happen in our lifetime.